I welcome you all to Dibeji's blog. This is about Adeola. Today is all about Adeola. Kindly comment below and let's celebrate her. This was a surprise party that happened to her last year. Don't forget to watch and watch to the hair. Thank you.
He's the careful one in the family. Me, I'm not. Plus, of course, I'm always excited when we travel together because it's like honeymoon, you know. So he was able to take time off work and we went to Texas. Meanwhile, Kodo was begging that he wants to go to Texas, so we had to take him along. So we went to Texas, and when it was time for my presentation, they took me into one room in the church to talk to the computer. It was online, so I had to, you know, talk to the computer because everybody was watching online. I'm like, why am I here? I can totally do this from home. Like, you know what I mean? I'm like, why am I in Texas presenting to an empty room? And then I found out that the other speaker, that is Dr. Alfred Tofade, was giving his own speech from his home in North Carolina. I was like, what? And the other speaker wasn't even here. Can you guys believe what Pastor Badru and his wife did? Azay! But you know, I was in the house of God, so I had to behave myself. But you know, it didn't make any sense to me at all. I gave my speech, and in the evening of that day, we had a talk show where three people asked me all kinds of questions. It was fire. It was a very, very hot seat. So I thought, oh, okay, maybe that's why they brought me to Texas, because of the talk show. I was like, oh yeah, that makes sense. You know, we were able to do the talk show, they were able to ask questions. So the next day was Sunday, and of course, we were staying for the service, and everything went well. I really enjoyed the service. The service was great, and we were about to close when the pastor said, there's one more video to play.
But I have one final video to show.
Happy birthday to you. Happy birthday to you.
So they started playing that, and in my head I was like, oh, it's somebody's birthday, just a day to my birthday. I was very excited for the person. Suddenly the video became more specific.
Tomorrow is somebody's birthday, but what stops us from celebrating her today?
She keeps things real and she's funny. For instance, bye. Bye. Why is she rolling the camera? Like Bamiyo.
Oh my God.
Good morning, good afternoon, good evening, and welcome you to Zibeji's blog. Wherever you're watching me from, kindly subscribe, like, and share this video if you are not part of this community. I celebrate journalist Adeola Oladele Fayum, the popular journalist. If you don't know her, I'm going to put her link in the description below. Keeping it true with Adeola, that's the name of her channel, and she has been married for 10 years, and God actually surprised and gave her a bouncy baby girl. Yeah, a bouncy, beautiful baby girl. Congratulations, and I rejoice with your family. I rejoice with your household. And this morning, she was excited with the baby. Appreciate God for the delivery. She gave birth like the Hebrew women, and she wrote on her Instagram page, I had plans for this birthday until someone who was due in June decided to make a dispute a date to my birthday weeks after she was due. Such a diva, trying to share birthday with me by fire, by force. She's the best birthday gift ever. So now we now have baby princess Victor, born July 6th, and Adeola July 5th. So they're going to be celebrating their birthday together. Ooh. Congratulations, Zibeji's blog. Celebrate you. We rejoice with you. Journalist Adeola Fayum gave birth to a baby girl after 10 years of marriage. I celebrate and rejoice with you, sis. Welcome to the world, princess, as God has brought you to the world. I declare Jeremiah 29:11 into your life. For I know the plans I have for you, declares the Lord. The plans to prosper you and not to harm you. Plans to give you hope and future. So shall it be in Jesus' name. You are covered with the blood of Jesus. And to the family of Adeola and Victor, I say congratulations, and we all rejoice with you. we rejoice with you. God bless you and stay blessed. I'm going to put a short clip of our previous birthday, last year's surprise birthday, into this video. So watch it. Don't forget to like, share, and comment on this video. Thanks.
Carolina. I was like, what? And the other speaker wasn't even here. Can you guys believe what Pastor Badru and his wife did? Azay! But you know, I was in the house of God, so I had to behave myself. But you know, it didn't make any sense to me at all. I gave my speech, and in the evening of that day, we had a talk show where three people asked me all kinds of questions. It was fire. It was a very, very hot seat. So I thought, oh, okay, maybe that's why they brought me to Texas, because of the talk show. I was like, oh yeah, that makes sense. You know, we were able to do the talk show. They were able to ask questions. So the next day was Sunday, and of course, we were staying for the service, and everything went well. I really enjoyed the service. The service was great, and we were about to close when the pastor said, there's one more video to play.
But I have one final video to show.
Happy birthday to you. Happy birthday to you.
So they started playing that, and in my head I was like, oh, it's somebody's birthday, just a day to my birthday. I was very excited for the person. Suddenly the video became more specific.
Tomorrow is somebody's birthday, but what stops us from celebrating her today?
She keeps things real, and she's funny. For instance, bye. Bye. Why is she rolling the camera?
Oh my God. So by that time I knew I was in trouble. By the way, the guy in the video was referring to a video of the promo I made for the church when they invited me for their event. Alright, I'll see you guys very soon. Bye. Bye. Did you not hear me say bye twice? Why are you still rolling the camera? So that's what he was mimicking. Anyway, so I started looking for a place to hide. You know, I'm a very shy somebody. So, but by that time, I could see my pictures on the screen. I was like, oh no.
Birthday to you. Happy birthday to you.
Happy birthday to you. Happy birthday to you.
Oh my God. Anyway, suddenly there was a cake in the front of the church. A beautiful cake with my favorite color red and Victor's favorite color white. I was like, how did they know? Like, for real? They even wrote Keeping It Real on it. I was like, shut up. Thank God that Kwaledo went with us by fire by force. So he was able to capture the moment. So that was how we were called forward, Victor and I, to cut the cake. And the pastor's wife, who turned 50, was the one that cut the cake. It was wonderful. Oh.
So we are going to cut the cake in the name of God the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. So, amen. Let's have a clap for Jesus. God bless you.
My Lord and my God, we thank you for your daughter.
You know, my head was sparking the whole time. I couldn't believe that they would do this, you know. It was literally our first time in the Houston area, so it wasn't as if we knew each other a long time ago. I only heard of them when they had their baby last year and I featured them. In fact, at that time, after I featured them, the pastor was trying to reach out to me that he wanted to thank me. I told the person that he sent, I said I was just doing my job, that he didn't need to thank me, you know. Anyway, so this was our first time of meeting them. And I was just overwhelmed and grateful. And I thought everything was over. I was so happy. Only for them to usher us into the chapel where they had set up tons of food and drinks. And suddenly I saw a big poster with my photos. I said, Father, namibi that. To cut a long story short, we had a party. That day, they really celebrated your girl. And that was when I realized why the church kept saying that they would love for us to come physically. Because up until that time, it didn't make any sense to me that I went all the way to Texas to deliver a virtual lecture. Ashe! Daddy and mommy knowingly tricked me out to Texas. Can you guys believe? You see why I had to come and report them. By the way, a week to this trip, this is just on the side, we were about to sleep one night when I told Victor that for my birthday this year that I wanted an iPad. He was confused because I have an iPad, but I said I wanted one of the newer models that I could use the iPad pencil to write on and one with bigger screen. I write my journal, so sometimes when I get in bed, I don't want to get up to use the laptop to write my journal. I just want to be able to handwrite it. So I showed him the picture of the iPad that I wanted and he was like, okay. Normally I don't ask for anything for my birthday. And then a few minutes after that, I said to Victor, I was like, you know what? Don't buy me an iPad. He's like, why? And then I said, I don't know, but I feel like God will give me an iPad. So I said, don't worry about it. He's like, are you sure? I can buy you an iPad. I said, I'm sure. Don't worry. It's not a need. It's a want. If God wants me to have it, he'll give it to me. And he was so puzzled. So that day in Texas at the birthday party, people gave me gifts. And I was like, oh my God, you guys, you don't have to. You guys have done enough. You don't need to give me any gifts. But they insisted. So we got to the hotel and we opened the gifts. And guess what we found? An iPad. Yeah. The newest version, the exact size that I wanted. And I just couldn't believe it. Victor was shocked. I was shocked. We called the pastor to thank him. And of course, Victor told him about my request for an iPad. But you know, I couldn't open that iPad for days because I just stared at it. I mean, I know it's an iPad, but to me, it's a huge reminder of God's faithfulness and how much he cares. And I just could not believe that he, you know, and I'm just so grateful to the entire King's Palace family. You guys made me feel special for my birthday. Thank you so much. I'm so grateful. All the guys that play the trumpet, I wonder how long they practiced just to sing happy birthday to me with their trumpets. I was really, really touched. I was like, oh my goodness. And all the technical guys, they went all out to put these videos together. It may look like a few minutes, but I know the amount of work that